Exactly what I was playing as the intro to New York State of Mind. Well, there's a reason why I'm playing that. It's because it's my newest tutorial that I have for sale. Well, at least at the time that I'm filming this. Who knows? Maybe it will have been out for 5 or 6 years by the time you see it. I don't know. But as of right now, it's new. And for $3.99, I'm going to walk you through note for note how to play that. All of it. Every last bit of it, not just the parts that are in the sheet music. The sheet music leaves out that whole little introduction, for example. But I'm going to go through, teach you that stuff, and I'm also going to teach you a few alternatives that you can use on some of the licks. For instance, when they go, and I don't want to waste more time. Between his live shows and the album, there's 2 or 3 different ways you can do that. I'm going to show them all to you. Okay, I want you to have options. So we're going to give you lots of fun fodder to use for this. Show you how to begin it. Show you how to end it. And if that wasn't enough, I'm going to give some of it away for free right here. And just shortly, you're going to be able to watch a free clip from the tutorial itself. And you'll be able to test it out, see what kind of a teacher I am, and get a feel for what it's like. So you can't beat that with a stick. So head over to pianomansteve.com if you like what you see. You can pick up the whole tutorial. You can pick up my other tutorials. At the moment that I'm filming this, I already have 18 of them done for Billy Joel. So they're very, very comprehensive. This is not one of those things where I just play it with the camera over my head and 8 minutes and call that a tutorial. I actually walk you through note for note what I'm doing with my hand, show you suggested fingering, show you the licks, all that good stuff, so you can really learn how to play it. It's been a labor of love my entire life. However big of a geek you are for Billy Joel, I promise you I'm at least as big, if not more. I have spent 20 years, a little over 20 years now of my life, learning these things the hard way. I want to save you some time. So that's what this is all about. I'll stop plugging now. You can watch your free clip. Head over to pianomansteve.com and be a part of my community. See my other video lessons and all the free stuff I have up. Enjoy yourself. And remember the one rule that I always live my life by. And that is, if you're not having fun when you're making music, you're doing it wrong. Okay, enjoy your free clip and I'll see you on the next one. Take care, gang. All right, well, we're going to get started with the intro to the song, the first part of the intro, actually. And this is one section that I had been playing incorrectly, and in the process of getting ready for this film, I have learned it properly, actually. Just one of those times where I had come up with something that was pretty close, and until I started taking money teaching people how to do it, it just never had the motivation to change it. But it's pretty cool stuff. Some really thick jazz chords. What we're going to do is you're going to find middle C. Your thumb is going to be on the G below middle C, And you're going to be on octave D's below that with your left hand like this. Okay? And what's going to happen is your right hand is going to go G. It's going to be G, G, G sharp, A, C. So bum, bada, bottom. Bum, bada, da, dun. Okay, and then you're going to come down on an F major 7 chord over a D bass, making it. The chord, the full chord's like a D minor 9 is what it comes out to, which is, you know, shop talk for D, F, A, C, and E, okay? Like so. And it's bum, bum, C, A, bum, bum, C, A, boom. Take your pinky out of the mix on that last chord. So bum, bum, bada, bum, bum, bada, bum. So the whole thing is. At full speed, it's like. A little frill that you do right here, and it goes A, it's A, A, B, A, G sharp, A, ba, ba, da, 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 ba, ba, da, 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 and it goes really fast, so it's like jump up to a B flat bass. It's B flat and F with your left hand, and then an A flat major 7 chord over it, which is A flat, C, E flat, and G, like that. And it's bum bum bum. 1, 2, 3. Bum bum bum. So again, it's. So there's a little riff here that goes bum bum bum. Excuse me, bum bum bum. And it's E flat, G, E flat, C, E flat. Except fast. So bum bum bum. Ba da 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 da. Bum bum bum. Ba da 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 da. Bum. And then you follow it up with just an A flat triad, A flat, C, E. So bum bum bum, ba da 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 da, ba dum da, ba da 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 da, ba dum da. Bum bum bum, ba da 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 da, da da da. Again, slower. Bum. Watch to that point the whole way through this intro. C triad in the second inversion here, which is G, C, and E over a D bass, and it's like this. You play bum, C, G. So E and G together, ba da da. So ba da da. Ba da da. Then a G triad up here the same way, only over an E bass. Watch this in context. Okay, so the next thing that happens is you go ba-da-dum, ba-da-dum, ba-da-bum. Then another F triad only here, A-A-C. Or excuse me, A, F, C. So, ba-da-dum, 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 ba-da-dum. And then from there you go to F major 7 chord, F, A, C, E over a D bass. And then it's bum, C, A, F. Bum, C, A, F. And then a G bass with an F, A, C, an F chord over it. Bum. I just play the chord twice. Bum, bum, and then you're ready to play right here. To a C bass with an E and a G right there. Bum. And then that's the beginning of the next section, which we'll actually get into, but I'm going to play through that a few times. Remember, it went... Watch this whole intro in context. I'll play it slow at a tempo, but remember, it's kind of free form, so there's not like a grid, like a 1, 2, 3, 4 going on. It's pretty much, you gotta feel it. Thank you. Yeah. Speed. So again, very much a freestyle tempo. You don't there isn't a right or a wrong way. You can hold a note, you can go fast, you can go slow, you can adjust that tempo as you go. It's very free form, okay? So I'll do that one more time, and then I'm gonna move on to the next section. Time and I'm not gonna I always try to keep my fingers out of the way, the ones that I'm not using I try to keep tucked under so you can see which notes I'm playing, but I'm gonna do it with my hands the way they look when I'm actually playing the song now. Ready for the next section in the next section. Okay, see you there.